I've just wasted a ton of cash on this MC4 crimping toolkit. If only I'd known about this before making my last video on why MC4 connectors are the biggest fire starters in solar PV installations. I might have saved myself from becoming the poster child for how to waste time with MC4 connectors. So what's changed? Staubli has launched a revolutionary toolless MC4 solar PV connector, basically a Wago style connector for the solar world. This means no more crimp, eliminating the need for an expensive toolkit. So before putting this toolbox up for sale on eBay, we thought we'd best put the new MC4 Evo Ready connector through its paces. While Staubli may enter this space a bit later than competitors like Weidmüller, who have had toolless options for some time, the backward compatibility with the original MC4 and Evo 2 versions is a significant advantage to using Staubli. This compatibility helps mitigate the risks associated with cross-mating connectors from different manufacturers. Let's look at attaching a female connector to a solar cable. The Evo 2 Ready connector is compatible with solar cables with 4 to 6 millimeters squared cross sections, a current rating of 30 amps, and a voltage rating of 1500 volts DC. Remove approximately 16 millimeters of insulation from the solar cable to make the connection. We recommend using this handy solar cable stripper from Weicon. If you haven't seen it yet, I'll include a link to our review of this tool. Once stripped, twist the conductor strands together. If you regularly overstate the length of things, the side of the Evo Ready spanners has a handy guide. Next, push the cable into the end of the connector. You should hear a slight click as it engages with the screwless terminal. Give the cable a firm tug to ensure the connection is secure. Then tighten the cable gland until it bottoms out on the threads. You can do this by hand, but it's much easier with specially designed spanners. Interestingly, Staubli recommends a torque setting of 3 to 4 Newton meters in the instructions, but I haven't yet found an adapter tool like the one included in the expensive toolkit. The process is the same for the male connector. Staubli advises that the cable remains straight for 20 millimeters when exiting the connector shell before bending. With all the stringent requirements around crimping the previous version, you might be curious about what's happening inside this new connector. It's time to break out the Dremel. We can see a spring terminal that resembles other screwless connectors. However, this design incorporates a unique carrier that guides our twisted conductor, effectively flattening it to maximize the contact area. As the carrier pushes the spring open, it moves through and latches into place, securely trapped by the spring, producing the audible click we hear during connector assembly. Once secured, the spring terminal firmly locks the carrier, ensuring the conductor remains securely attached to the contact and cannot be removed. It's time for the pull test. Based on our experience, a properly crimped original MC4 terminal is exceptionally strong. Let's see how this new version compares, and it is nowhere near as strong as the original. But does this matter? The connector also requires tightening the cable gland to seal out moisture and provide strain relief. That was underwhelming. So let's get back to the bin. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this new connector. If you've already used it in the field, please share your experiences in the comments. If you're on site and possibly having to deal with someone who wasn't very diligent with the solar connections, this tester could be the answer to your prayers, and you can find out all about it in the linked video on screen now.